Good day, everybody. Connor McIver. Welcome to today's Santa Clarita Real Estate Daily Radio Show. I'm, of course, your host, Connor McIver. Today, we're going to talk about responsiveness in real estate and why is it that sometimes it feels like your agent's keeping you in the dark and maybe not wanting to give you the truth. Maybe they're holding something back. Maybe they're trying to not give you information that could help you make a particular decision or other issues and topics. One of the things that I will tell you is this. Prior to getting into the show, we'll talk about three different systems that we uploaded real estate intel to this morning at 00:30. What I did is I went to SantaClaritaHousingMarket.com. I put the condo and townhome updates there. SantaClaritaHousingMarket.com. So you can check that out. That's our Market Mondays, one of the installments for Market Mondays. You'll see the brand new condo townhome reports. You'll be able to digest those, tear them apart, and I did upload those for each and every city here in Santa Clarita Valley. So that's SantaClaritaHousingMarket.com. Then, if you want to see the single-family residences, I did upload those this morning and also gave some insight as to where the real estate market is and where it should be going here in the next few months. You can get there by SantaClaritaRealEstateMarket.com. SantaClaritaRealEstateMarket.com. You'll see all that information there, and you'll be able to, of course, digest that as well. And finally, the real inventory, real numbers, the real data, it's going to go and it's going to be on realtor.paris911.com. Realtor.paris911.com. That's really kind of the main stopping ground because on that particular post, I did upload the information so you can get over to those other two websites I talked about. When if you're looking for condo townhome information, and of course, if you're looking for single family residence information. So you'll be able to see that. So that'll be very exciting for you, as it is for us. As far as real estate data, within the last 7 days, we've had 103 brand new listings hit the market here in Santa Clarita Valley Cities. You can get that intel by simply punching in the word new into the Mac box at our main site at Paris, P-A-R-I-S-911.com. Punch in the word new into the Mac box, and then you'll see each one of those 103 listings. 52 properties have their prices changed during the last 7 days. That should be good stuff. We'll check that out this Friday. You can tune into last Friday's show and kind of get an idea as to where those prices were. Are they going up? Are they coming down, staying stagnant? And what do these price changes have to do with the local market? Check out last Friday's show. And this week, of course, you can tune in the coming Friday and check it out. We'll be talking about price changes, how they relate to the market. 37 properties failed to complete escrow, went back on the market, and that's something that has a lot of sellers upset, at least 37. For the most part, real estate dealings, when they don't make it through escrow, it's not for reasons that a lot of people suspect. It's not really because of a condition of the house thing. It could be that the buyer lost their ability to finance. It could be they lost their job. Maybe they got laid off. It could be that the seller wasn't going to move forward and assist the buyer in any way, shape, or form. Heck, maybe the appraisal came back on that particular house less than you had written the offer for, and that appraiser is lower. And, of course, then the seller will accept, right? So then you have that issue as well. Let's talk a little bit about communication. We've given you the websites. In real estate, whenever you're purchasing a residence, you're in touch with your agent quite frequently. Whenever you're selling a residence, it should also be the same. But any party to any real estate transaction, buyer or seller, should always have the talk from the real estate agent so they can understand how the market works, understand responsiveness and time frames. When you're writing an offer on a piece of real estate with your agent, after you get it all put together, you talk to the agent. How long are we giving them to respond? A couple days, typically. That's usually about the correct amount of time. It depends. If it takes them longer than that to respond, what happens? Well, really nothing. Nothing happens. If it takes them an extra 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 hours to respond past the deadline date, and they sign off on it, it works. It still moves forward if you decide. if they come back and they sign off of on it early, your offer, or they counter you prior to the expiration, that still works. So all that's great. However, what if the agent isn't responding to your agent? Does that happen? Believe it or not, it happens way more often than it should. So send in an offer. The agent isn't getting back to your agent. Your agent might not have called the agent. You have to make that physical phone call. You really have to call them directly and say, hey, this is Connor. I just sent you an offer. Would you please let me know if you received it and if it's complete on your end? A lot of agents won't pick up the phone. That then becomes a big problem for you as a real estate buyer, because you're wondering, huh, why hasn't my agent called me back? Why didn't they give me information as to where we are in the process? Did I get the property? Did I not get the property? What do I have to do? Aren't they going to respond? There's a lot of these questions out there, but the speech includes giving those types of stories that surround making offers on real estate. For example, a couple weeks ago, some clients of mine and myself, we've been looking for properties. Finally, we found the one. The listing happened to have been taken by a way out of area agent, an agent down in Long Beach, no offense to Long Beach agents. And the phone numbers that they put and the email address that they put on the MLS data sheet within the Board of Realtors was lacking. The email address that was in there, in fact, got kicked back as undeliverable. And the phone numbers that were in there were to an office. And you might think, well, that's great. It's an office. Not all offices in real estate are staffed during business hours each and every day of the week, even Saturday and Sunday. Some are, but most are not. So if your agent submits to one of these types of agents that doesn't have any personal contact information, when the personal contact information is screwed up, then what happens next? Well, you're not going to get a response, especially if that offer is submitted Friday afternoon, maybe 1 or 2-ish in the afternoon. Then all of a sudden your agent submits the offer, all's well and good. He can't even get somebody to acknowledge receipt. Plus, the email's no good. So now, while this property is just sitting there, you thought you had an offer in on it. Realistically, nobody's given any kind of acknowledgement to let your agent know, oh, yes, we have it, and the email's bad. So there's other ways, of course. He can go Google the agent, see if he was careless and left his cell phone number online. God forbid to have clients contact him, say, hey, can you help me? I want to buy and sell a house. But at least, you know, for the other agents, right, to try to track them down. So I looked online, there weren't any phone numbers. His name was incredibly common, so I was running into that issue as well, trying to run different keywords in Long Beach to see if I could pull up some kind of a website that might have some other information about how to get in contact with him. So it never worked. In fact, I wasn't able to talk to anybody at the office till 11:30 Monday morning. And as far as the agent goes, it took me 3 or 4 days for the agent to actually reach back out to me and say, yes, we did get your offer. And by the way, we have 12 other offers and we're going to be countering everyone. So then that was another several days in the process. But if I wouldn't have explained that story to other clients, then they wouldn't really understand how the process works. And they would be a little irritated that, because it gives an appearance that I'm not doing my job, I'm not conducting the proper follow-up. And that's a situation, a scenario that happens on the buyer's end of it. Then we move over on the seller's end of it. Here's one of the speeches and the things that we speak about with regard to sellers. If somebody calls me and says, hey, Connor, I'm going to be writing an offer on 1234 Anywhere Street. The thing that I will not do, and I explain this to my sellers, I'm not going to pick up the phone, I'm not going to call you and tell you. Because I can't tell you how often some people say that they're going to be writing and then the client changes their mind. Happens. I can't tell you how many times the agent calls and says they're going to write the offer when the agent hasn't even, the client hasn't even been pre-qualified for a loan. So they find out that the person wanting to buy the house cannot purchase, so they don't move forward. So these are issues, and these are things that need to be talked about. With regard to real estate sellers out there in the world, the other thing is when agents go into their house and the agents are saying, oh my gosh, what a beautiful house. Oh yes, my client's going to love it. Oh my gosh, can't wait. We're going to go back and we're going to write an offer right now. We just can't wait. You know, we got to do it immediately without delay. All this stuff. Now, if the client hasn't had it explained to him that a lot of people like to engage in pillow talk, agents especially, when they're looking at properties, talking to sellers, if I wouldn't have explained that, then every time that were to happen, the client would be totally wrapped up and really wanting to call me every single moment, which is fine. My clients can call me 24/7, 365, but I don't want them to misunderstand what people are saying when they're viewing their residential real estate listing. So these are parts of the process whenever we explain to our clients how things in real estate happen to work, and that's incredibly important. So again, three resources. You can go to realtor.paris911.com and you can see the Santa Clarita condo and townhome reports. It'll be a red link. You'll see it right there under the market watch for the last 7 days, the recap I did this morning. And then under that, you'll see the single family homes market update as well. So we talked about inventory levels. This is something I'm going to throw out there, and then I'll close out the show. Whenever you're searching for real estate online, and you start to look, you know, here and there, to and fro, you're going to run into websites that are giving these numbers that seem a little bit higher than what you might find on the actual multiple listing service, and this is why. Some of those systems are actually rigged up to get you to give up who you are, to get you to give up your name, your phone number, all that information, email address especially, so they can then take that information and sell it to agents willing to pay for it. That being the case, be careful online, because sometimes some things are too good to be true on the internet. Today, 561 active listings, 329 listings in backup position, 311 listings are currently pending. So you take the pending, you take the backup, and you take the active. That's a lot going on out here. I hope everybody has just an absolute wonderful Monday. I don't know if that's even possible, but I'm going to reach out there and hope that you will. I'm Connor McIver. Check us out online. I am with RE/MAX's Paris 911 team, RE/MAX's Santa Clarita Valencia. Look forward to helping you. Reach out to me if I can, and I will be thrilled. Everybody have a wonderful day. Be safe, and I'll talk to you soon.